unshakably calm, the Sternguard veterans are renowned amongst their brothers for their exemplary marksmanship in the fiercest of battles. We'll be showing you how to paint an Ultramarine Sternguard veteran quickly and easily, and by following the guide, you'll be able to get the whole unit painted up in no time. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn more about it. The paints we've used in this guide are listed on screen now. We're painting in the colours of the Ultramarines, but remember, you can paint your miniatures however you like. Also on screen now is any additional equipment we've used. This includes brushes and mediums, but feel free to use whichever brushes you're most comfortable with, and if you don't have mediums at home, you can use water instead. So to start off, we've undercoated the model, and for this we've used Macrag Blue. It's also a good idea to have a pot of Macrag Blue to hand. This'll help us if we need to tidy up any mistakes later on. So the first areas of the miniature that we're going to be painting are the gun casing and the undersuit. For these, we'll use Abaddon Black. This is a base paint, so we need to thin it down with some water and apply it to the miniature in a few thin layers. Doing this avoids clogging up any of that fine detail we can see on the miniature. We're using a medium layer brush for this, as it's small enough to give us plenty of control, but it's a little bit larger too, so we can paint a bit quicker. Now in this video, we're only painting one miniature, but these do come in a unit, and you might prefer to paint them all at once. This is called batch painting, and all it means is that we paint more than one miniature at once. So for example, I'd do all of the Abaddon Black on all the miniatures in the batch I'm painting, and then move on to the next stage. Now we'll be painting the helmet and the trim, as well as any parchment on the miniature, and we'll be doing this in Corax White. Again, sticking with that medium layer brush to give us plenty of control, we'll need to thin the paint down and apply a few layers to the miniature. When you're painting the helmet, it's especially important not to build up texture on the model, so make sure that the paint is really thin, but not too watery. Take your time and work your way around the miniature. If you do make any mistakes, don't worry, you can always tidy back up with the previous colours. Just make sure to thin your paint first. And with the first two colours done, we can see the model already starting to take shape. Next, we're going to move on to Celestra Grey, and we'll be using this for the rocks and the Crux Terminatus. We'll be applying this just like we've done with the other base paints. Take your time and work your way around the model. Be as neat as you can, but don't worry, mistakes can always be tidied up. However, if we're neat to start with, we'll get a better end result. Now you can see that our model has a cloak, and for this, we'll be painting it with Wraithbone. As we're going over that blue undercoat, this will take quite a few layers. Stick with it, it's worth the effort. Just remember to thin your paint and build it up with several layers. And make sure that each layer is completely dry before you move on to the next one. Next, we'll be using Mephiston Red to paint the eye lenses and the Purity Seal Wax. You might prefer to switch to a small layer brush here, as it'll just give us a little bit more control. This is a really nice bright red, and even when we've washed it later, that nice bright tone will still come through. Now we're going to paint any pouches and straps that we can see on the miniature, and for these, we'll be using Mournfang Brown. This is a really nice warm brown and it complements all the other colours on the miniature. Now we're going to move on to some metallic details, starting off with Leadbelcher for the silver. If you're ever unsure where to place certain colours, you can refer back to the box art or choose for yourself. This is a metallic base paint, so we treat it just like the others, we thin it down with some water and apply a few layers. Just be careful not to get your paint too watery as it will separate on the miniature. Now it's time to paint that gold, and for this we'll be using Retributor Armour. Once again, thin it down and apply a few layers. We don't want to clog up all of that detail we can see. Now we're just going to pick out those few unpainted details in Balthazar Gold. Again, this just adds a bit of variety to the miniature. And once that's done, all our base coats are finished, so we can move on to some other stages. Now we're going to be applying Agrax Airshade. And we'll be using this on the parchment, the gold, and the brown. We'll be using this in two different ways. First of all, we're thinning it down with some Larmier medium. So we'll take two parts Larmier medium to one part Agrax Airshade. Then we'll apply this over the parchment. Doing this means the shade is more subtle and doesn't overpower the miniature. As we've got that really bright base coat, this is especially important here. Next, we'll be taking it straight from the pot and applying it onto the gold and the brown. You could also pick out the Purity Seal wax in this colour too, if you like. When you're applying a shade, just be careful to control any pooling on the miniature. If you find it is pooling too much anywhere, clean off your brush and use that to soak up any excess. You can avoid this by making sure you don't overload your brush. And with that first shade on, we can see how the model's really starting to come together. Now we're going to use Basilicanum Grey and Contrast Medium. We'll be using this to paint over the silver, the eye lenses, and recess shade in the armour. Again, we'll be using this in a couple of different ways. Now you might notice that this is a contrast paint, but it can work really well as a shade as well if we thin it down. So to start with, we'll be thinning it down with one part Contrast Medium to one part Basilicanum Grey. You'll see that this adds lots of depth and age to the miniature. We'll also apply this carefully over the eye lenses. Don't worry if you do make any mistakes, just thin down some Corex White and tidy back up. Next, we'll take the paint straight from the pot, and we're doing something called a recess shade. This means just dropping the paint into the very recesses where the armour panels meet. If we apply this all over those flat surfaces, it will change the colour of that armour. We want to avoid this, so applying it just into the recesses means we get lots of depth. Now it's time to recess shade that cloth. For this, we'll be using XV88 and thinning it down with Larmier Medium. Doing this creates a wash consistency and allows us to just drop it into those very deep recesses. We'll be thinning this down with 5 parts Larmier Medium to 1 part XV88. You'll see that this adds a really subtle amount of depth. As this is such a pale base coat, we need a really subtle shade just to add some depth without overpowering it. Now we're going to do a similar thing with Calgar Blue and Larmier Medium. Again, we'll be thinning this down to create a shade consistency. And we'll be applying this over the white areas, just dropping it into the recesses like before. You'll notice on the box art that there's a blue shade in the recesses of the white areas, so this is our way of really easily replicating that. We'll need to thin it down using 3 parts Larmier Medium to 1 part Calgar Blue. Using paints like this in a variety of different ways is a great way to achieve lots of different effects on a miniature and get the most out of your paint. Now your Sternguard veteran is more than ready to deploy where the battle is fiercest. However, if you'd like to see an easy way to take this paint job up a notch, stick with us. Now we're going to use Calgar Blue again, this time as an edge highlight for that blue power armour. We'll need to thin this down with a touch of water before applying it to the miniature. Where you can, use the edge of your brush. Running the edge of the brush along any panel lines will create the highlight really quickly and easily for us. And there we are, your Sternguard veteran is finished. And by following the techniques in this guide, you can easily paint up the entire unit and deploy them onto the battlefield in no time. And now you can see that we've also applied transfers to this miniature and we've based it too. We've based it using a technical paint called Armageddon Dust. And if you'd like to learn more about technical paints, you can check out our video all about them. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, you can head to your local Warhammer store where our awesome staff will be more than happy to help you. Or head on over to citadelcolour.com. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video and we'll see you next time. Bye!